name is Lily Ashley, and I'm going to say two really short poems, sorry, one is about Suzanne's still life with a plaster cupid, and then the other one is about Gauguin's Nevermore. Also, I'm like very conscious of the fact that I've got lots of art historians in the room who are going to be like, she's saying it wrong. Yeah, okay, sorry. Cupid, Cupid, you little shit, warping my view. This whole lonely world spins around you. You're irresistible with your creamy frame, but you distort reality and it explodes my brain. I really feel for poor Suzanne. Obviously, a love-possessed man, obviously screwed over, just like me, with the pressure to play happy families. Sat in your studio, day after day, Cupid mocking every word you say, till finally, fed up with feelings hurt, you look to the little plaster twerp. And you reach for a canvas of modest size. You start mixing your paint through narrowed eyes, and you paint, and you paint, letting tables fall and floors fly up and into walls, and apples rest where they should roll, Cupid in the center with complete control. But look, oh, look at what you've made. A still life of a world enslaved. Got my rhythm. And this next one's about Nevermore, which is over there. So it would be better if I was over there. But you guys can just look over there and, like, for reference. And this is about, you know, women being naked. Because it's really interesting. I was reading upstairs that people are shocked by pubic hair. Who knew? That's cool. That's not. That's very modern, isn't it, to be shocked by pubic hair? How much longer must I lie here, waiting for you to be done? I like the idea of immortality, but this isn't very fun. To be constantly re-evaluated, constantly picked apart, wondering what it is I am thinking, all in the name of art. Well, I'm wondering what they're doing behind me and what you're all staring at. My underdeveloped bosoms, because she was really fucking young, or the hairs around my twat. And although I'm a fan of Suzanne, I'm fed up of staring at lakes. Of course I can see their beauty, but my patience is starting to ache, so I'll let you in on a secret of what I want to see on these walls. A reclining male nude with a nice set of cock and balls.
All right.